Hey, it's Brenda Adelman here. How are you? I have something pretty exciting for you today. Some teaching. So, for those of you who don't know me, I have been teaching on the power of forgiveness for, I could say a decade. Yeah, for well over a decade. I actually received a Hero of Forgiveness Award in 2008. And I've been focusing on helping people tell their stories, their core story, their hero story, really realizing how you are the hero of your life if you do the inner work, right? If you bring conscious awareness to part those parts inside of you that hurt. And so today I'm actually going to do a quick training on how to release some resentments so that they're no longer in you, because those resentments hurt you. They don't hurt the other person. I mean, maybe they hurt the other person, but how many of you are super angry with somebody and think that they're being punished because of it when half the time they're people who don't have remorse? They don't have empathy. They don't think like you. So, it's like maybe it's a nuisance or a bother, but they're actually not hurt. But you're hurting yourself because if you're like me and the people I work with, you're sensitive, you're an empath, and you have compassion and you have heart. And so you don't understand how people can just hurt other people and not think anything of it, right? Let me tell you my big story for a minute for those of you who don't know me. My name is Brenda Adelman, and I've been teaching this work. Nobody goes into forgiveness, I don't think, because they haven't lived a well-lived life or experienced big betrayal. And all of us have experienced betrayal in some way, shape, or form. Certainly here in America, I will say, because whether it's a lover's quarrel or someone who's cheated or a child that doesn't, listen or doesn't call, or a parent that is emotionally abusive or not there, or things like that, right? Well, for me, my father, who I adored, I did shot and killed my mother, who I adored. She was my best friend, but that wasn't enough. He married her sister. Oh my God. So I got the betrayal of my father and all that goes with that. And then I have him marrying my mother's sister, like moving in with her within a month after he shot and killed my mother. Okay, so I lost my whole family for all intents and purposes. I did reconcile with my brother, thank goodness. And went into depression, went into self-loathing, somehow thought I was damaged goods because of what happened with my family. Hey, say hello. Then realized, hey, I'm not damaged goods because that happened with my family. Let me explore this. Let me look within. Let me see how this happened and I didn't see it coming. Where was I in denial? And what does it mean about me? And can I get through this? And do I have courage? And can I find love again? And more importantly, I think for me was, can I trust again? Because I trusted my father and look what happened. So look in your life and say, have you trusted someone who didn't deserve the trust? Like, I think my work's about opening our eyes, helping you open your eyes. And a big part of my work is helping. Well, for me, it was I had to take responsibility. I had to look at where I was in denial and I didn't see things. And I work with clients with this, especially around divorces or breakups or different situations where they really blame someone else, or even really blaming a parent. But after you're an adult, a parent that's still emotionally abusive after an adult, well, if you go see them and they're abusive, that's on you. That's not on them anymore. No matter what, I've heard so many people be like, well, I have to see them, because they're elderly. Oh, no, you don't. Yes, there's consequences, but why would you put yourself in a position with someone who shows no remorse, who's emotionally abusive to you when you're an adult? That's just habit. Okay, so I'm going to help you get out of that today. Hey, say hi, please. This is from my book, my Kindle book. My father killed my mother and married my aunt, Forgiving the Unforgivable. It's a workbook as well. This is a printed version, but there's a Kindle version. Okay, so this is one of the exercises in it. And I'm sharing this with you. This is kind of an advanced exercise because I am so passionate about this material, and I have created a 30-day program starting October 1st, which is called Phoenix Rising, A Journey to Forgiveness, that I want to take with you. And this is the kind of thing we're going to work on, except it's going to be all laid out every day with a daily homework assignment, if you choose to do it, let's say action plan, and an affirmation every day. It's going to be 30 days of the deep journey into forgiveness and mostly self-forgiveness, because it's an inside job. You can't even really forgive other people unless you forgive yourself. It's the same thing with love. You can't fully, truly love someone else unless you fully, truly love yourself. So that's what the basis of my teaching is. And that's the good news. It's an inside job. And even when I say forgive other people, it's like I forgave my dad and I took him to court for wrongful death. And I never saw him again, but I forgave him so that I could free that energy inside me that was resentful and angry every time I thought about him. I don't want to carry that shit. Then you're bonding. I was responsible for bonding myself to him with my anger, right? So join me for those 30 days. I will pop a link later because I don't have it in there now. I'll pop a link below. And if this resonates with you at all, you have any questions, join me. This is going to be a deep exploration. And I can hold for you, right? Okay, so let me give you these exercises. So one is bringing the unconscious to conscious awareness. Step one of my three-step process is a lot about moving out of denial and into acceptance of what is, because it is what happened for me. You know, we don't want to hear what we don't want to accept what someone's done to us, so we just go into denial. And sometimes it is a survival technique, certainly for kids, but it's for adults too. I just chose not to believe the facts because emotionally I couldn't bear the fact that my father shot my mother and killed her. However, I didn't have someone guiding me. I didn't have someone with compassion who really knew the psyche to say, that's okay. It's okay for you to be where you are right now. You can be in denial right now. People do this with cheating all the time, right? Oh, it's not really happening. That person's not really doing it. Or a business partner who has stolen money, or someone who's not trustworthy. I want to help you move out of denial. And part of that is taking what's unconscious and moving into conscious awareness. So take an honest look at yourself and your relationships that trigger you and ask these questions. Are you judgmental of yourself? Are you judgmental of others? Honestly, a lot of people, we don't like to identify as judgmental of others, but you know, we're human. It's almost like habit. We judge other people sometimes because of our low self-esteem. Right? We want to feel better then, so we might judge someone else. Judgment is different than discernment. You can say, I don't like what someone did, but if there's an emotional charge, then it's judgment as well. And judgment hurts you. You can use discernment and say, that's not for me, and that's healthy. I want you to then write down all the judgments that you have about yourself and or someone else. And here it is. Write down the payoff you're getting for it, because we don't hold on to beliefs and thoughts unless we're getting a payoff. We just don't. So this is where it's time for radical responsibility. You must figure out what your payoff is. This is the exercise for today, but we're gonna be together for 30 days. So you might get a new exercise every day. You're certainly gonna get a training every day from me, a short training and an affirmation every day to change it. So this is just an example of what we'll be doing together. So let me give you an example of how, from my life, this works. So I might say the judgment I had, certainly after my mother died, but I judged her before too, was I began to judge my mother as a failure because she didn't leave my father. The payoff, because you're looking at your payoffs, is I can hang on to my righteousness and not feel guilt. The guilt that underlies everything in my life back when I wrote this or when I was becoming aware of this was that I could not save my mother. So this is deep stuff. When you take this 30-day journey with me in Phoenix Rising, a journey to and through forgiveness, it's deep, right? But the thing is, so the payoff was that I could be angry and righteous about my mother not leaving my father because she should have, so that I don't have to feel guilty over the fact that I couldn't save her. Well, the reason why people don't usually do this is because they go into deep remorse. I could go into deep remorse, and I did for years. I don't want you to go into deep remorse about the relationship you stayed in, the relationship you left, the job you left, the child you didn't care for. I don't want you to go into deep remorse, but I want you to get serious as far as really moving out of denial. However, this is where, when you don't know how to do this work, you go into remorse and you beat yourself up. But my work is about radical self-love. I feel like all those judgments are really an invitation to love yourself more. So I teach about the self-forgiveness and the self-love in the course, so that you identify all of these and then you dissolve them in a wave of self-love, okay? Oh, I don't know why that went off. Oh, because it's getting dark. Okay, I'm going to end this. Let me see if there's something. Let me give you one more before the lights go out. And then I have like another example. I'll use this one in the course. Another one is, I, Brenda. So think about someone in your life that really betrayed you, okay? I mean, you can come into this course, so affordable. You can come into this course and work on smaller issues, but why not go for the big stuff? Because I can hold for you. That's the thing. I've been coaching since 2006. It's my honor to hold a space for you. The reason I started coaching on this is because nobody could hold for me because of the amount of rage and despair that I had earlier on. And I realized everything I learned to heal myself, I could use to help other people, okay? So the second one is, I, Brenda, judge my father as cold-hearted and untrustworthy. Of course, right? So think about someone in your life. Well, what's the payoff? Why do I have to hold on to that? Or why does that come forth? And for me, it was, I feel this protects me from feeling bad that he was no longer in my life and gives me the strength to keep him out of my life, right? So there was a huge rift after my mom died. He cut me out because I was trying to hold him responsible and he didn't want any of that. And so by me judging him as cold-hearted and untrustworthy, I could not feel that pain of abandonment so much, and it helped me to stay strong. And that goes into having a boundary, but it's a hard boundary, right? When I would cut him out of my life because he was untrustworthy, he was not in my life and I wasn't playing his games, it kept him out of my life. That's a hard boundary, and that is a first step. But in the 30 days together, we're going to talk about how do you change that. Maybe that hard boundary is necessary at first. The judgment, we want to release the judgment. Like I could have said my father is cold-hearted, because that would have been accurate. But without the energy of, and it's wrong, and he's so horrible, and how could he be my father? Like, that's the stuff to work on releasing, and so that it's not toxic to me, right? It's not draining my energy. It's not making me isolate. It's not making me be afraid of people, not making me fear intimacy. It's separating it. So it's self-awareness, separating the judgment from the emotion so that you can use discernment. Still decide not to have the person in your life, but then switch from a hard boundary, cutting someone out of your life, to a healthy boundary. And the way you do that is when you radically love yourself. And so you make choices from self-love, right? So I'm going to pop a link in here for you to join me in Phoenix Rising, which is what you are, which is what I was. And it's a journey to and through forgiveness for 30 days, starting October 1st. Apropos, October is Domestic Violence Awareness Month. So for me, it's really important, and it's also kind of auspicious. I do a lot. Like, there's a lot of energy. I'm usually presenting my story in public, which I am. I'll be traveling in New Mexico and presenting my story then. And I'm going to be taking you with me on the journey to and through forgiveness. I'll pop a link in so that you can join. I can welcome you and we can get started on October 1st. Okay, if you have any questions, let me know. Use this exercise. Tell me how it was. And remember to love yourself radically while you identify the payoffs you've been getting for holding on to unforgiveness. Okay, please share this too, and please post. Let me know that you saw this and if it was helpful. Okay, bye.